So that's Buy the World a Drink off the Gaslight Roses album. Interesting, R&R picked it out as a song that really is tipping the hat to out-and-out country music. Was that a deliberate choice?
It wasn't a conscious decision, but country was definitely on our minds. I think going into this record, I'd never written a straight country song, but was listening to so much of it at the time. A lot of Gram Parsons, you know, Hank Williams was a big thing, and so it was bound to come out. And sure enough, I picked up this lyric that Mark had sent, "Buy the World a Drink," and just as soon as I opened it up, just those chords came, you know, and that kind of gentle kind of country lilt. And it just wrote itself. It was a really easy song to write.
And obviously on the album, you've got the introduction of Steel Pedal with the brilliant Chris Lee joining in. So that's added a new dimension as well.
Yeah, I mean, getting Chris Lee on there was a dream. It's just, I've always wanted pedal steel on our records, and Mark had suggested he play on the album, and it was brilliant to have him, and it just adds that flavour, and it just takes you to a place straight away, and you know, so a lot of my favourite records have got that sound on.
And before I hear, it's not exactly a new lyric either.
No, I didn't know at the time, but Mark told me sometime afterwards that it's actually, the lyric's about 30 years old. He'd written it a long time ago, and so he's been living with it for years, and so I think it was strange for him hearing my melodies to a lyric he'd written so long ago. But he loves it as well, so we were really happy with that one.
All that I know is I could buy the